We've waited years for new Fluke multifunction testers. Now the 1670 series is finally here. But what's so great about them? What can they test? We're going to find out. The Fluke 1670 series multifunction testers make testing about 30% faster and include new testing capabilities not previously available on the 1660 series. We'll get to those later with Jit Patel, Fluke's product manager, but for now, Mark, Fluke's technical sales manager for the UK and Ireland, is going to give us an overview of what each of these models can test. So without further ado, Mark, there are three models in the 1670 series, 1672, 73, and 74.
Yes.
What can each of these testers do?
Okay, thank you. Well, the 1672 is our entry-level tester for the series. This one will do all the regulatory tests that are required, from voltage and continuity through loop impedance and resistance tests, as well as RCD testing. All these features are established and well-renowned within the industry, and obviously our tester helps you not only perform these tests, but helps you to easily document them in our new format that we've put into the tester series. And the 1673 tester also has additional features, including what I mentioned in the 1672. The 73 has Bluetooth technology built into it, which encompasses not just the Fluke Connect, but also the ability to connect to earth testers like the 1630 series, and also earth leakage testers like we have with the 369 tester as well. Both those are able to capture the information within the unit here and put them into a format that's easily alignable to ensure that you've completed all those tests as well. On top of that, we also have an Autotest feature that's built into it as well, and it has the added features that it also can be used to test EV charging test points as well. These can also connect to our FEV 300 and our FEV 350 electric vehicle testers. And with our 1674 unit, it also has the features as previously explained in the 1672 and 73, but it has added benefits. Those being, it has SPD, surge protection device testing, IMD, which is insulation monitoring devices. It has a fully programmable auto test sequence that can be customized however the user wants to. And it has our tried and tested established pre-insulation test as well. So overall, it has a lot more functionality than we've ever offered in our installation testers.
You can read more about the testing capabilities of the 1670 series via the links in our description. And remember to look out for our video on their reporting capabilities. If you're after a quick overview, do look out for our introductory video. Now we get to the first totally new test available on all 1670 models, voltage drop. Please tell us about that.
Okay, thank you. Yes, you're right. Voltage drop is a feature that we've added to the 1670 series. Basically, what we're looking to do is ensure that between the distribution board and the furthest point on the actual circuit is that we don't see the voltage drop below 3%. This means that if it was to exceed that value, then basically you might start seeing problems with flicker potentially. Okay, and that there would be obviously a feature that we see as being much more prevalent in testing today.
Now we're going to move on to tests that are only supported by the 73 and 74. So if you want more information about 1672, please click the link in the description or look out for our video on the 1670 series reporting functions. So moving on to the 1673 and the 1674, let's talk about EV testing.
Okay. Well, EV testing, obviously, as you know, is more and more in demand as the requirement for EV charging points to actually be dotted up around the country. So Fluke, obviously, like all tester manufacturers, have embraced this and basically offered a unit that can do those tests. We have adapters called the FEV 300, and they can be used in conjunction with our 1670 series here and the 1673 and 74, as you rightly say. These are the conduit to obviously take and record and document the electrical measurements using the EV adapters, basically. And then on top of that, we have the FEV 350. Again, they can also help do the testing and store their information, the results, and document them within the 1670 series here. And one of the added benefits that we have with the 1673 and 74 is they have the ability to test RDC, DD, EV charging test points as well. This is a feature that hasn't always been available on all our units, but it is now available on the 1673 and 1674.
So the FC in the 1673 and 1674 model name stands for Fluke Connect.
Yes.
And that isn't new, but how has Fluke Connect been updated for these models?
Okay, well, Fluke Connect, as I say, is not a new feature. It's been around for a while now. But what we've done is embrace the Fluke Connect within this unit because more and more people now are needing to build up more information and document this. As I said before, the 1670 series is all about documentation. So with Fluke Connect, we can now tether that to earth testers like we have the 1630 earth tester. That's able now to collate that information and assign it within a position here within the unit, and you can physically see the information on screen and assign it to relative new circuits and distributions. And then on top of that, we also have like earth leakage, where we have the 369 leakage clamp, again, to help document that and put those leakage currents that basically that would flow. And we can document them again to individual circuits on individual distribution panels.
So it improves reporting and documenting.
100%. That's the whole essence of what we've really built and geared the 1670 series around, is that ability to capture, document, and put all that information together easily. And one key feature about Fluke Connect as well is that it is completely wireless technology. There is no need to connect anything. These units obviously have got line of sight, and therefore they're able to transmit that data and easily connect without any trailing wires at all.
Can I clarify, is that wireless via Bluetooth?
It is via Bluetooth, and the Fluke technology, the Fluke Connect technology, I should say, is seamless. It connects very seamlessly. It's just a press of the button, it activates, and the information flows freely. And on another thing, one of the things with the Fluke Connect technology is it's mobile. This is on your app, obviously, and you can connect it. You can see the information that you can see whether you've recorded it, how it's documented, and all the results that are obtained are all contained there within the system and on a cloud-based package.
And is the app free for iOS and Android?
Yes, it is, 100%.
The final thing that the 1673 and 74 have in common is the Autotest function. Please could you tell us a bit about this and how it differs between the two models?
Okay, well, the 1673 has an Autotest feature, like you rightly say. Autotest allows the user to actually go through a sequence of predefined tests within the meter, so he covers all the expected tests that he needs to do. It means that the user, when doing something like the RCD test, he can stand at the distribution board and reactivate it when the RCD trips without making those returns back to the meter, which could be a distance away. And it enables the meter to capture all them and position them full within that circuit board, a distribution board, where you've allocated it. So it makes very efficient use of the engineer's time when doing the testing. When we get to the 1674, that goes one step further and then goes towards programmable auto test sequences. We can talk about that in more detail, because every user may want to do something slightly different. They may want to do more RCD tests. They may want to do more insulation tests. They may want to remove a test for whatever that reason may be. So have the ability to customize it is a very much a unique feature that we're offering.
I imagine that makes testing more efficient as well.
Most definitely.
The next tests we're going to talk about are unique to the 1674. So if you want more information about the 1673, now is the time to click the link in the description or find our video on the 1670 series reporting capabilities. Thanks, Mark. That was really informative. Now we're going to talk to Jit Patel, the product manager for Fluke, the man behind the tester, if you like. And he's going to give us some more information about the tests unique to the 1674. Well, hi, welcome, Jit. We were just talking to Mark about the Autotest function on the 1674. Could you talk a little bit more about that for us, please?
Sure. Thanks for having me, Jess. So one of the things that we thought was really important to add to this instrument is actually automatic testing. Now, automatic testing isn't as easy as it seems, because, you know, an electrician will do testing in a certain way. So it could be that you want to do all your dead tests first or your live tests, but you can't actually do them together because you have to set up the system. So with the auto testing, we have some what we call predefined auto tests. So they'll go through a sequence for you, which is found in the 1673.
Yeah.
Now, when you move on to the 1674, we have programmable ones, so that we can actually do that testing in the order in which the electrician wants to do them in. So he may want to do all of his live tests first, or all of his dead tests, or a combination of the two if it actually suits his testing. So by introducing that, what we've done is we are preventing from having to set up all of those tests, which take part of that time, which goes towards that 30% improvement in testing time. And then also the fact that it moves from test to test, so you don't take a long time actually moving between tests and performing those tests.
Now we're going to move on to the second of the new tests. This is only available on the 1674. Please, could you tell us about the insulation monitoring device test, please?
Sure. So insulation monitoring devices actually work by giving you an alarm or a visual alarm or audible alarm. So when they're actually set up, if there is a breakdown in insulation down to the protective earth, then the alarm will go off. So what this tester allows you to do is to simulate that error or that fault, and do that by actually introducing different resistors into ground. So what we do in the instrument, we can set up the different resistances. It will tell you if there's that breakdown in insulation, and then you can check it according to the manufacturer specifications or according to how you've set up that device itself.
And why is this useful?
This is useful because when you're talking about IT systems, that you have, if you have a breakdown, it doesn't work in a standard way like you do with RCD protection. So this is a way of making sure that the system is safe by using this insulation monitoring device.
So the third and final new test, again, this is only available in the 1674, is the surge protection device test. Please, could you tell us about this one?
Yes, sure. So, you know, a lot of electricians will have seen SPDs or surge protection devices, you know, in even domestic situations now, they're getting more and more prevalent. And the reason why they become more prevalent is because there's a lot more devices, sensitive equipment on circuits, like your iPad and, you know, all these games devices, things like that, that can get damaged by surges. So a lot of surge protection devices are being put in. And there's not really a way of testing those easily, but, you know, a lot of people want to know, is it working correctly? So the SPD test allows you to actually select a voltage, so either 500 volts or 1,000 volts. And what it will do is it will ramp up in insulation to cause that to actually trip after passing more than 1 milliamp. And so what the device will do is it will trip, and then the instrument will tell you how much voltage it took to actually cause that to trip. It will first do it in DC, and then it will do the calculation to AC so that you can check it according to the SPD device and make sure it's working correctly.
And are there any other tests or features that you would like to draw our attention to on any of the models?
Sure. I mean, when it comes to testers, the tests themselves are pretty standard. You know, ones that you would do to be able to test a BS7671. Now, where this instrument really comes into its own is really the user interface, how simple it is to work with. So obviously with a touchscreen, it means that we've got a different way of actually entering information. And obviously from a documenting perspective, that's very important because I'd like to put in, you know, what type of circuit it is so I can enter it using the onboard keyboard. So the interface is very important from that perspective, but actually working around the interface. So basically it's very simple. I'll get up on the screen what it should be. I click onto it and I just work through them and press the test button and do my measurement.
Yeah.
Then it's as simple as pressing either the save button to save the measurement, but also we've got a new form in there where we can actually create a table. So by actually setting up your circuits, so circuit number 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., a lighting circuit, a cooker circuit, whatever circuit that is, it will basically create a form for you. And what we can do is we can work from that form. So say, for example, I want to do an insulation measurement on a cooker circuit. I click basically into that cell, it will go into that particular measurement. I perform the measurement and then press save, and it will automatically put that into the table for me. And I work through that whole table, and by looking at that table, I can straight away see whether I've missed a test or whether something's failed.
Yeah, I mean, it seems the whole design of the 1670 series is focused on efficiency and user convenience, and that really does play into that, doesn't it?
Yes, very much so. And productivity is very important. I mean, you know, whilst actually developing this unit, we had over 250 interviews with customers just to find out exactly what they're doing, their pain points with the instrument. One of the biggest things for them, and in fact, it's just a comment coming from electricians, was that, you know, when they do their testing, the customer sees that time that they perform all their tests, but they don't see the documenting time. And they don't see that that's something that they should pay for. So the quicker they can do that, the better. So we wanted to make sure that the actual electrician could do that documenting as quick as possible. So being able to get all that metadata, so to speak, on site, not get it wrong, not miss any tests, and be able to transfer that to a report is very important. So that's what we're trying to do here, is really, is make sure that all their documenting is very quick. They could actually create a certificate and give that to their customer and get paid as soon as they can.
So considering the testing capabilities of the 1670 models, what would you recommend each model for, or to whom would you recommend each model?
Sure. So the 1672 obviously is our entry level, and I would say the entry level into documenting. So if you want something that allows you to document quickly, 1672. Now, I would go maybe with your domestic electrician. Probably does a reasonable amount of testing and needs something that will do all the measurements to be a 7671 and wants to do documenting. So your domestic type user. If we then move to the 1673, where we have, for example, the earth ground testing, the automatic testing, then maybe the more commercial user. So, you know, doing more tests, but in commercial type environments, maybe some industrial, obviously some domestic as well.
Yeah.
And that person could be someone who's doing a lot of building sites, doing multiple homes, etc., where they just need to bosh out their certificates. So maybe that's the sort of person we probably see as a 1673.
Yeah.
And then obviously 1674, again, you know, the usual thing, you know, like me, maybe you just want the best instrument out there. You know, we all like our tools. But then a lot of industrial maybe type use, but also the need for, you know, speeding up your measurements through the auto tests and being able to do the sequence and create your own sequences. SPDs are becoming, you know, more prevalent. So yeah, if you want to be able to do SPD testing, then yeah, go for the 1674. And then, you know, it's kind of, you know, they will all do the testing that you need to do to conform to the standards. It's just, you know, as you go up in features, what you want to get from them.
They become more and more future-proof almost as you go up.
That's right. And that's a really important thing that you bring up there, because one of the things about this is that, you know, it is very future-proof from the perspective that it has a very powerful processor. It has lots of memory. You could actually update this in the field. So any changes to the standards, we'll be able to put a update on the Fluke website. You'll be able to put that onto a USB stick.
Yeah.
Place that into the instrument and update your unit. But we really are confident in being able to make sure that this is future-proof for a long time because of this really powerful processor that we've got in here. It's not an embedded processor that literally all the other testers have. So on top of that, one of the things I forgot to mention was the fact that both the 1673 and 74 both have capabilities for testing EV.
Yep.
More because they can actually test RDCDDs, which obviously you find in EV charging stations. So yes, if you're going to do like a lot of EV testing, then, you know, look at the 1673 or 74. One of the things I forgot to mention is one of the things we can actually do with this and the display, because we've got this color display, which is touch, is that we can actually flip the screen 180 degrees. And the reason why we want to do that is because we've added another capability which we learned from our customers in Voice of the Customer, that they have problems sometimes testing at distribution boards.
Yeah.
So typically you've got it around your neck and it's kind of flapping, it's hitting, it's right up against the distribution board, for example, or they can't see it. So one of the things we wanted to do is allow for them to actually hang this on the metal door. The way we do that is we've got a magnetic hanging strip, which actually connects to the neck strap, and then you can actually hang it. When you actually hang it, the thing with that is that you would have the instrument this way around because you need the leads to come out.
Yeah.
And so you would have the instrument upside down. But as you can see here, we can flip the screen 180 degrees, and that allows us to then see the whole thing 180 degree flip. But also it changes the interface with the actual rotary encoder there so that it's going left to right in and working in the same manner you'd expect it to when it's the right way around. So we do the full interface change there so that you're able to use this instrument easily.
Great. Thanks, Jed. And thanks, Mark, who is now over there. Remember to check out the links in the description and look out for our future videos. See you next time.